this feeling that something was terribly wrong with the world we live in, but you couldn't figure out just what it was. You've come to the right place. Secret societies, mystery religions, and the Illuminati have been controlling our reality since the beginning of time. But not anymore, because there is an awakening happening, and you are about to become a part of it. Wake up, because this is a call for an uprising.
6 million people in Southern California now ordered to cut back on using water. The region is facing a historic severe drought. Officials there just declared a water shortage emergency for the first time ever. According to these new restrictions, people can water outdoors just one day a week. It applies to parts of Los Angeles, Ventura, and San Bernardino counties. The restrictions begin June the 1st. The water supplier in the region reports if cities don't enforce it, they'll face hefty fines. Record drought is straining water systems all across the Southwest. And now officials say it's also threatening one of the region's biggest sources of electricity.
California could soon see stricter water usage rules. The reason is rather obvious. It's because of the state's drought.
KTEL Advisor Aaron Myers is live in Sherman Oaks this morning with a look at how Southern Californians will need to cut back. Aaron.
Hi, you two. Good morning. Most of California is experiencing severe or extreme drought conditions right now, so many Southern Californians may only be able to water their lawn once a week in about a month or so. Now, at parks, it could be a little different. Cities will be able to determine how water is used at spots like Van Nuys Sherman Oaks Recreation Center here, as officials want to reserve them for the community. Earlier this week, officials declared a water shortage emergency, which will affect about 6 million people in Los Angeles, San Bernardino, and Ventura counties. California is in the third year of a drought. In fact, Southern California had its driest January through March ever. The restrictions are being called for by the Metropolitan Water District of Southern California and will apply to areas that depend on water from the State Water Project. The State Water Project brings water from the Sacramento-San Joaquin River Delta to farmlands and cities south of there. The district wants residents and businesses to cut water use by at least 30%. Cities and smaller water suppliers, six water suppliers as of now, will be required to restrict outdoor watering to one day a week or find other ways to cut water usage to a new monthly allocation limit, or they could face fines. Not all of the six water suppliers will necessarily require once a week watering, though. For example, Inland Empire Utilities Agency will be asking customers to increase conservation efforts. Other areas are still meeting to decide what to do. Officials say there are various ways residents and suppliers can cut back.
This is a call for an uprising. Welcome to today's show. By now, we're all aware of the planned food shortage, what they're doing on purpose, and blaming on Ukraine. They're blaming it on supply chain issues. They're blaming it on trains. They're blaming it on hackers. Pretty much everything, including the Tooth Fairy, is going to get blamed for the food shortages, and people will never be suspicious of their own governments doing it on purpose. And another thing we need to keep an eye on is this planned, deliberate attack on our water supply. If you haven't noticed, water shortages are on the rise, and they're even telling us now that we can expect 80% decrease, an 80% decrease in water. Now, this is being done, obviously, deliberately, because our government actually has the technology to create rain if they so desire to. We know that Operation Popeye was used during the Vietnam War, that they were using it to mud out the enemy, to cause deliberate rainstorms and things like that. We know they have the technology to create as well as to divert weather patterns. And of course, they're doing the latter of the two. They're diverting weather patterns. They're making sure that there's massive amounts of brush storms, firestorms being created all over this country on purpose, because they easily, according to them, and according to what they've done and used as a weapon during war, they could easily be able, or easily could be able, to create something to combat this, but they don't, because they use the weapons that they have against their own people. And now, of course, we're going to see, along with the food supply, we're going to see droughts, and we're going to see water supply chain issues, because remember, to control, and by controlling the food and the water supply, they will be able to control the people. You cannot live without food and water, period. So how else are they going to get people on board with their new industrial revolution, their new technological advancements to take the mark, to be a part of this new world that they're trying to create. They'll control the food and the water, and they'll tell people, well, you're going to have to comply to our government and to this new government that we're putting in place, and we'll feed you and give you water so you can survive, but you're going to have to go along with what we say. And this is part of the problem that we live in now. We allowed our government, that we became dependent on our government for food and water. You think, oh, you go to the grocery store, it has nothing to do with your government. Of course it has everything to do with your government. They control all of these food manufacturing plants. They control the FDA, who puts the food on the shelf. So not only are they, you know, are you becoming dependent on them for food and water, you're also becoming dependent on them for food and water that is laced with chemicals, which is why you've seen such an increase in depression. You've seen such an increase in diseases, diabetes, you name it. It's because of the crap that they've been pumping into our food and pumping into our water supply. But we know that they can do certain things with the weather to, you know, create storms and cloud seed. They openly talk about it. Why wouldn't they just, you know, do something like this to help?
Controlling the weather is the ultimate super weapon. It's even more powerful than the atomic bomb.
Many world governments are pouring billions of dollars into research designed to manipulate weather.
This is the master control room. Electronic maps and view screens display up-to-the-minute pictures of the weather around the Earth. Every hour, reports are automatically received from all points at sea, on land, and in the air. 22,000 miles out in space, three robot satellites train their sensitive television eyes on all parts of the Earth. These pictures are monitored on viewing screens in the Weather Center. Machines digest the constant flood of information received from all stations. This is then translated into an ever-changing diagram of the Earth's weather. Forecasts for every sector of the globe are made months in advance. Prediction charts have indicated that a powerful hurricane will begin forming today in the Atlantic Ocean. The electronic weather map shows an intense storm system building up about 1,000 miles due east of Miami, Florida. The controller calls for a close-up satellite view of the troubled area.
Coco 526, Yankee 2.5.
Okay, controller. Coco 526, Yankee 2.5.
The characteristic swirling clouds of the hurricane are beginning to form. Anticipate the violence to come. The controller calls for a last-minute prediction of the hurricane's path. If control measures are not begun at once, the hurricane will smash across densely populated areas within 48 hours.
WMEST. A hurricane is forming 960 miles east of Miami, Florida.
Control measures are ineffective. It will pass inland at Cape Hatteras in 48 hours. Control operations will begin within 2 hours, but safety precautions should be completed from Cape Fear, north no later than 6 p.m. tomorrow.
At Weather Central, the control strategy is mapped out. A ridge of high pressure slants across the eastern United States between two low-pressure storm systems. If these two storm centers are intensified, the high will build up along the coast, forming a barrier that will turn the hurricane out to sea.
Stand by. Now pulling in satellite number one for visual check of low pressure systems L20 and L21.
The operator brings the satellite into focus on the two storms. One centered over Kansas, the other over Labrador.
Changing to northeastern low, L21.
Of a button, the battle begins. On the ground, chemical cloud seeders begin to work the two storm areas. Robot planes seed the clouds from above. The storm centers over Kansas and over Labrador intensify as seeding continues. specially equipped robot aircraft are dispatched immediately to release a high concentration of cloud seeding material into the fringes of the storm. Heavier seeding from the ground also helps to subdue the rain by spreading it over a wider area. The controller calls for another view of the hurricane, which has now moved closer to the coast. Have been brought into play. Now we can only watch and wait. Far out at sea.
increase crop devastation in 80% of the world by 2050. The study warns as Western states are scorched and the United States' biggest reservoir is drying up. Researchers study current and future agricultural water requirements to 2050. They did so to determine whether required water levels would be available. The team from the Chinese Academy of Sciences in Beijing looked at maximum levels of water possible from rainwater and irrigation in each cropland area. They created an index to measure and predict water scarcity in water sources, and they found that 80% of croplands would fall short of what is needed. So with all this crazy technology that we have, you'd think that maybe they would do something to prevent this, but of course they want to use global warming as a cop-out, as an excuse, so they can gain more control over the citizens and blame us for it, right? Blame the energy and the gas and the carbon, all the crap that they spew out. And all these imbeciles don't realize that these people are doing it on purpose to gain more control and more power over citizens, because you cannot live without food and water. So what better way for them to do it than to cut the food supply and to dry up the water reserves? Makes perfect sense if you were playing a game of Risk, the board game, and this was an option to, during a war, in some type of situation, you say, yeah, why wouldn't we do that? Then, the war, these people would just die off. Well, guess what? The war is going on, the war against the civilians of the world. The governments all over the world have turned on the civilians. They've been plotting and planning to do this for a long time, and now the pieces are in place, and of course, the dumbing down of society has gotten so bad that it's pretty much, they could openly admit that they're doing this and it wouldn't change anything, because the people are so stupid with this TikTok era that we live in, where people are getting paid millions of dollars to be complete imbeciles. And of course that's being glorified in the media and glorified on places like YouTube, because they want to continue dumbing people down while they continue to take control of all the resources, and they have full control. We know that. So the water scarcity, we're seeing this in California, we're seeing it in other places. Reservoirs are really just drying up. By the time they're talking about 2050, I'm talking about 2025 to 2030, okay? Because this is going to be a big thing that they factor in with, obviously, the food supply shortage. Now, you can go weeks without food. People don't realize that. You can go a couple weeks, but there's people who fast for weeks and are perfectly okay. Obviously, it's, not easy to do, but there's people who do that. You cannot go for an extended period of time without water. And dehydration is legit. I mean, if you've ever been dehydrated before, you probably didn't even know it. You do not want to get in a situation where you're dying of starvation and dehydration. And they know that. And they know that, the school system's never taught anybody how to even, find resources for water, where they could go. People don't know that they can pretty much dig down deep into their ground in their own yard and find water. But, there's plenty of things that they do on purpose, pretty much everything, I should say, they do on purpose to keep everyone dumped down and unaware. Because the only way they'll really be able to control people is to be able to control all these things in their lives that people should have control over. They should always be thinking about where they're going to get their next meal or what food they have stored up in case of a shortage or in case of, anything. But they don't think like that. They've got everyone thinking the opposite way of an Uber-type lifestyle, right, where your next meal is a phone call away. But, if the grid's down or there's an EMP or the power, it's completely off, you're not going to get your meal. And then you're going to have nothing in your fridge or your freezer, and the power will be off, so anything in there will, go to waste, and people don't have stored up food, and a lot of people throw away stored food that they have because of the expiration dates, which are not accurate, which, people put on, they put the expiration dates on there based off of taste, how good it tastes, 2 years from when you buy it. And then people just throw it out because they think it's just going to make them sick if they eat it. People are constantly not keeping things stored up, which is exactly what they wanted. So they have the ability to take care of situations like this, because they have the ability to control weather. They have the ability to control storms. I mean, you've seen, that was Disney showing you how they can control the direction of storms and things like that. 60 years ago, Disney, 70 years ago. People still don't think they have the ability to do it. It's pretty insane. I mean, the technology that we have, or that they show us that we have, and people don't think, they're like, well, the governments are still trying to figure out how they can, do this with the weather. Meanwhile, I've covered stories on here about how they create, storms in Dubai using graphene and other things. And, people are just like, no, they don't have the ability to do it. Why would the government ever do that to its people? I mean, we've seen dictatorships, we've seen
governments have turned on their people before. I mean, it's amazing the operation that they're pulling now, because what they're pulling is like trying to create this illusion of an incompetent government and then distract people with the most ridiculous nonsense that is so nonsensical. It's insane. Talking about what a woman is, talking about, we have people going crazy off the Roe versus Wade, even though it's on a federal, it still goes down to the state level. Nothing has changed. And it's just unbelievable. It's unbelievable. And this is what they have planned. They're quietly underneath the surface. You just see all these stories about food and water issues. And people are so dumb, they don't realize they can't live, I think, at this point. I'm pretty sure that the majority of people don't realize they can't live without food and water. Right? But it's something that people have taken for granted their entire lives, is food and water. You know, how many people wake up every day and are thankful that they have running water and they have food in their refrigerator? Not many, because they're thinking about some useless thing that they have to do that day, because that's how they've trained all of us to think in this society. People aren't grateful for things, they take things for granted, and then when crap hits the fan, they'll realize, oh my gosh, right, I'm not prepared to not have food and water. I can't live without it. It probably should be the most essential thing in my day-to-day life on my mind, but it's not. The most essential thing is, where are you going to take your next selfie? What's it going to be of? What can you post on Instagram to make people give you hearts and love you? I mean, it's just, no. Wake up, snap out of it. People won't. So you can expect massive stories over the next few months, I would expect, with some of these reservoirs, especially in the summer here in California, in Nevada, other places where they're just going to say, look, it's drying up, because they've been mentioning it over and over. We know over the years that they've obviously created a lot of these storms, a lot of these forest fires, and they easily could have cloud seeded to put these fires out. And nobody asked the question. It goes, yeah, didn't we do that during Vietnam, where we actually created using weather manipulation, we're able to do that. Oh yeah, we were. Oh, but we haven't mastered it yet. So we'll just let all these forest fires continue to go and destroy people's homes and their property, and people don't realize that they're doing it on purpose. Pretty insane. So expect the water supply thing to be a massive issue tied in with the food supply issue as well. Because remember, this is all about control, and there's two things that if they take control of both, and they already have control of it, that they'll get people to be on board. That's why people will take the mark. People will go on board with this stuff. Everyone's like, no one's ever going to go on board with it. Oh, yeah, wait till you're dying of starvation and dehydration. Then you'll be on board. Not you and me, the people of this town, because we're willing to die, obviously, for our faith, because we know what is happening. This is biblical. This is prophecy being fulfilled. But other people, in a heartbeat, they'll take all these things that they're told to take, because they've got society under their thumb. I mean, they've got them in the palm of their hands. It's pretty scary. Reminder, check out the website at callfornuprising.com. It's 299 a month. I hope to see everybody over there. I want to thank all you guys for